Inasal is the tastiest chicken this side of the world, and it's also very easy to make.
Have you both been to Bacolod?
Mm-hmm.
You have? You, Daniel?
No, never.
Okay, but you like chicken inasal, right?
Yeah, I love it.
You?
I love chicken inasal.
Do you want to learn? Well, I'm going to teach you how to make authentic Bacolod chicken inasal.
Yum.
Okay? Now, what's really key here in making inasal? It's just vinegar made from coconut milk.
Oh, it can't be any vinegar.
No. It, that's what makes it authentic. The moment you use, how funny, because I used to think, my gosh, Bacolod, there's so much sugarcane, so they might use sugarcane vinegar. They don't, they use coconut vinegar.
Aside from the sinamak, as the Ilonggos call it, the tasty marinade for chicken inasal calls for soy sauce, crushed garlic, grated ginger, calamansi juice, and crushed lemongrass. Aside from the barbecue sticks, we will also need a brush to use with our basting sauce made of melted margarine, oil steeped in annatto or achwete seeds, pepper, and delicious chicken fat or oil. All that will go on the chicken cut of your choice. I'm using chicken legs today for that flavorful dark meat. Na meat!
You sometimes, when you have chicken that's broiled, sometimes you experience that it's not cooked, right? Mm-hmm. Which part of the chicken is not cooked?
The joints.
The joints, right? So what we're going to do is make serrations or cuts near the joint so that the heat can penetrate.
Okay.
Okay, maybe Tours, what you can do is you can make serrations. Okay. Okay, so Danielle, why don't you start making the marinade for soy sauce muna? You're about 1/2 cup of soy sauce. Okay, more padding. Okay, the soy sauce is a lot stronger. Yeah, okay. That's good. Then the coconut vinegar. Yan. So yan, okay na yan, Tours. Basta near the joints, okay?
Mm-mm. How much of this should I put?
3/4 of that, darling.
Sinamak is more than just coconut vinegar. It is a spiced magic potion made with lots of siling labuyo, langkwas or galanggal, garlic, whole peppercorns, onion, and salt. No wonder Ilonggo cooking is so flavorful.
What do you smell?
It smells like sweet and sour sauce with vinegar.
Okay.
Yeah.
Tours, watch your finger, huh, darling?
It's like kind of citrusy.
Okay, I can smell that tamna. Then put the garlic and the ginger, darling, here. Put the garlic. Okay, put everything there. Okay. Ginger. Okay. Then the calamansi, sweetie. Go, all of it.
And as always, keep tasting your food as you go along.
Oh my gosh. There you go. Okay, just put everything here.
It's kind of spicy, but not too spicy, but at the same time, it's a little sweet.
Yes, that's exactly what you're going for with the inasal marinade.
You know, in making Bacolod chicken inasal, the basting sauce is different. Did you know that? This is a marinating sauce. You can keep this overnight, okay, in the refrigerator if you want. Look at this.
Ew. So they marinate it overnight?
Usually, yes, so that the flavors penetrate. So you remember the serrations that you made? Okay, those are going to penetrate the chicken inasal. You want to get the back of the knife, okay, and pound it just so that the juices of the
lemongrass
come out. Okay. Interesting.
Like I said, ideally, the chicken should marinate in the sauce overnight. But even 30 minutes will make a huge difference already to the chicken's flavor.
Now, what you want to do then is get some barbecue sticks. You know, with the barbecue sticks, what you do is you wet it in water. Dip it in water so that when you grill it on the char grill, because sometimes what happens is the chicken oil falls into the charcoal and what happens?
Burns.
It burns, the fire comes out, right? Now, if it catches fire and this is not wet, it's dry, it's going to burn the...
Yeah.
Burn the sticks.
Yes.
Smart,
yeah.
So those are already soaked in
water? Yes, they've been soaked in water. So you just go like this.
So where are you piercing it through? Through the leg and the...
Leg and the soft part of the meat. So you put two pieces of stick. Yeah, like that. And then we're going to grill this, just like this. Okay?
Okay.
I'm not going to lie. The extra pairs of hands in the kitchen are fantastic.
Okay, so while I'm putting these sticks through these, how I eat my NSL usually is with lots of chicken oil and chicken fat and with garlic rice always. And actually, I used to not like spicy food until I tried the sili in the sauce. Then I started liking spicy food.
In the inasal.
In the inasal sauce.
You, Daniel.
In the inasal.
I noticed you have a ritual, like when you eat your fried chicken, what do you do?
I shred it first before I start.
So remove
because
all the
bones. You gotta fillet it before first. You play.
What? You gotta work first before
pay
you
play. Now, play later.
Pay now so and play later. That's right.
Once it's all done, you can just eat.
You know what? This may actually be my first Great Pinoy cookout with my kids here in the Philippines. Hooray for new memories!
This is hard.
Mm-hmm. You have a technique.
Anyway, you do this every day. My gosh, after a while, it's gonna be a walk in the park.
Once all the chicken is skewered, it's time to make the basting sauce. It all starts with some melted margarine.
Actually, this is the star of our basting sauce. Okay.
Good one.
And then, what we're going to do is, Tours, can you pour in some of the achuete? This is just
strain
for coloring. Yeah, strain it through the ano.
How much?
Maybe about a tablespoon. Yeah, okay na yan. Sige, sweetie.
Can you use butter?
It's gonna be different if you wanna make it taste like authentic ano. Inasal, you have to use margarine. That's the star of the show. And then we put chicken oil. Now, the way you get chicken oil is that you have some excess skin. You can start it off with a little oil, and then you slowly saute the oil until the oils come out. And then that's what you use to baste it with. Now, what you want to do is we have to start grilling our chicken. You grill it with the meat side first.
With the meat side first.
Go ahead.
The trick to delicious chicken inasal? Keep basting it generously with the margarine sauce all throughout the grilling. It should only take about 20 minutes for each piece of chicken to finish cooking thoroughly. Smoky, juicy, tasty chicken inasal right in the comfort of your own backyard. That wasn't so hard, was it? Appear!